This is the gospel booklet you wrote for Reformation Heritage Books a few years ago now. I think it's probably in 36 languages all over the world. Perhaps you can tell us why you wrote it. Yeah. And have you heard any reports about how God is using it?
We hear quite a few reports around the world. The reason why, that's the result of flying on airplanes. And what I mean by that is, if you notice, it kind of goes through everything. And the reason why is I was always sad, like, if I witness to someone on an airplane and they seem to be interested and then we have to get off the plane, or if someone were to make a profession of faith, you know, after you've talked to them, what do you do? And so what I wanted to do was to give them something that would go back through everything we discussed, but more thoroughly, and then also other things. So there's, who is God, you know, because that's where it all starts, the nature of God. What is man? You have to know those two things. What has God done? The divine dilemma of God being able to satisfy his own justice and show mercy to the wicked. Then going on about the resurrection. Why is it absolutely essential? And then from there, to actually say, you must believe. What does it mean to believe? And then how can you know that you believe? And repentance. What does it mean to repent? And how can you know that you actually have? And then give them certain biblical principles on assurance, that they might grow in their assurance. And then something like, what should you do now? Like reading the Bible and prayer and fellowship and being a part of a biblical local church. And then a few things about, what is a biblical local church? If you were to go somewhere, what would you be looking for? And it was kind of like, if I only had one chance with a person and could never talk to them again, I wanted something I could hand them. And that's how that book came about.
It seems every few weeks I get a new version. Some look similar to this with a different language on the front, from Nepal or other countries like that, and people using it all over the world. I've seen evening news stories on New Zealand TV about this booklet being dropped into cults and people reading it and coming to the true gospel.
I've heard about that, yes.
So we've seen people, churches using this by the hundreds. It's been such an encouragement to hear God using this message. And I also hear that, you know, even in Brazil right now, yes, they're giving hundreds of thousands of these away,
yeah,
and spreading the gospel around certain cities there. Yeah. So it's so encouraging to see how something just a few years later can have blossomed. I think we're in like our 12th print run now.
Yeah.
So I encourage you to, you know, be encouraged and other people to use this.
Just for the sake of other ministers and other preachers and writers, if you'll notice, there's really nothing flamboyant or eloquent there. It's just explaining, using scripture, the things that a person needs to know, the essentials in order to know Christ savingly and then to go on with him.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's definitely not about eloquence. It's just put those scriptures in front of people in a way they can understand them.
Yeah, this is jam-packed with scriptures, and it can be a quick read with somebody, or I've had people use this for weeks on end, slowly going through every reference as well. So what are those essential elements of the gospel that we must get right?
Oh, well, first of all, people always say sin is the problem. You know, sin is the number one problem. And that's really not true. You have to go deeper. If God was unjust, if God was sinful, if God's nature was different than it is, then sin would not be the problem. So the number one problem is God is good and we're not. And so that has to be set before the person. They have to know who God is. My people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Or in Psalms 50, you thought I was like you. I will rebuke you. So they need to know who God is. Then they need to know the truth about man. You know, people will get so angry when you begin to expound the biblical view of man, but it's nonsensical. In the same way that someone shouldn't get angry when the faithful doctor says you have cancer, it's terminal, but we can do this. You know, we have to tell people the truth, and we do them no favor by withholding what Scripture actually says. But then we don't leave them there. We don't want a repentance unto death. We want a repentance unto life. And we show them Christ. Show them, look what God has done. Look what He's done. Look at the power of this. These were the things that were necessary to accomplish. This last Adam accomplished them all. Now, what must you do? You know, destroy the idea that salvation is by works. I mean, just destroy it. And that's why it's so important to talk about the sinfulness of men, so that they come to the end of themselves, so that the only place they can look is up. And then show them not only that God can save, God's willingness to save. God's willingness to save. Oh, His willingness to save is so, it's infinite. And then, you know, what must you do? You know, we use terminology a lot of times. So when we talk about the essentials of the gospel, it's repentance and faith. You can't leave somebody there. Both those words mean nothing unless they have a biblical definition and they're biblically illustrated. So that's important. And then I think one of the most overlooked powers in evangelism is explaining to someone what does justification actually mean. It's not just, okay, your slate is wiped clean. It is, you have been clothed in the righteousness of Christ. You are now, what could we say? You're imprisoned in the love of God, and there's no way to escape. Now go on, walk with Him from glory to glory. Those are some of the essentials.
So I encourage you, perhaps buy a pack of 10. It's really cheap, very inexpensive, but not the message. It's the most valuable thing we could give to anybody. Have them in your car or your bag ready to give out, or in your church. Buy hundreds, give them out in your locality. God is using this. We can testify to that. So thank you so much.
God bless.